फाइनेंस फॉर मैनेजर रिविजन वीडियो क्वेश्चन वाइज इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इन दिस वीडियो. सो वी विल स्टार्ट विद फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन. डिफाइन डिप्रिसिएशन. व्हाट आर द कॉसेस फॉर डिप्रिसिएशन. दिस इज द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन. फॉर दैट क्वेश्चन वी आर गोइंग टू गिव the important hint point, that is hints we are going to see. So here as usual we are going to give the meaning for depreciation. Depreciation is the gradual and permanent decrease in the value of an asset. This is the meaning for depreciation. So these are all the causes for depreciation. So we are dividing the causes into two: internal causes, external causes. In the internal causes, first one wear and tear, second point maintenance, third point disuse. Next, external causes, two we are seeing here. One is time factor, second one is technological advancement. So these are all causes for depreciation. So here we are seeing the theory part questions, important points. So first question was over. Next we will see the second one. The second question is, explain the various factors which influences the dividend decision. So here we are going to see the what are all the factors which determines the dividend decisions. First one, amount of earnings. Second one, stable earnings. Third one, growth prospectus. Next one, cash flow position. Next one, tax policy. Third question. The third question is, explain the advantages of fund flow statement or fund flow analysis. So we are going to see the advantages of fund flow analysis. So first advantage, changes in financial position of the company. Second advantage, reason for changes. Next, third advantage, level of working capital. Fourth one, future business. Last one, company image. These are all the advantage we are getting by analyzing the fund flow analysis. Next, question number four. Explain the importance of capital budgeting. This is the fourth question. So for this we will see the important points, that is hints. So first importance is calculation of future cash flow. Second important, helps in the long term goals. Third importance, control of expenditure. Next one, wealth maximization. Next last point, new opportunities in the market. Before going to this first fifth question, once again I am reminding, these are all the important points. By keeping these points, you have to develop the answer in the examination. This is the tips we are giving. So those who have seen this revision video, first video and second video, there I have explained how to develop these points. You have to make these points as a charts, and after that you have to take one by one and explain. This is the format. So you please memorize this point, and after that you please develop this point in the examination. So now we will see the fifth question. Discuss the importance of working capital. So importance of working capital, that is the question. So what are the importance of working capital? Here we are going to see. First one, higher return on capital. This is the first importance. Second importance, improved credit policy. Third one, higher profitability. Next one, higher liquidity. Last one, increased business value. These are all the importance of working capital. Next we will see the question number 6. What is break-even analysis? Explain its uses. Those things only we are going to see. That is uses of break-even analysis. So these are all the uses. First one, business funding. Second one, cost control. Third use, production planning. Next one, make or buy decision. Last one, keep the risk in check. These are all the uses we are getting by using this break-even analysis. Next, question number 7. The question is, what are accounting concepts? This is the question. So for that, the answer is, accounting concepts are, first one, business concept. Second one, going concern concept. Next one, money measurement concept. Next one, accounting period concept. Last point, dual aspect concept. So these are all accounting concept. Next, question number 8 we are going to see. So question number 8 is, discuss the various methods used for capital budgeting. So these are all the methods of capital budgeting. First method, payback period method. Second method, net present value method. Third one, internal rate of return. Last method, profitability index. These are all the methods of capital budgeting. Ninth question, explain the objectives and functions of financial management. This is the ninth question. So we are going to see the objectives of financial management. So objectives are, first one, profit maximization. Next one, proper mobilization of finance. Next one, company survival. Next objective, proper coordination. Last objective is lower cost of capital. These are all the objectives of financial management. So next, 10th question, explain the importance of ratio analysis in the business. So importance of ratio analysis, that is the question. So answer, aid to measure general efficiency. Second importance, measure financial solvency. Third importance, facilitate decision making. Next one, corrective action. Last importance, aid in inter-firm comparison. These are all the importance of ratio analysis. So here we have discussed nearly 10 theory questions with important points for the paper Accounting and Finance for Manager. So you have to memorize these important points for each and every question. By keeping these important points, you should develop the answer at least some 3 to 4 pages in the examination. So many people are asking about that problem. Already I have given the word that is there. They are asking only trading and profit and loss account problems and the fund flow statement problems. For these two topics, I told you earlier that I will give you the format for this two method. So many people are asking, sir, you please give me that format. So next video I am going to prepare that only. So very shortly I am uploading that also.